Hello children, in the previous video lesson we started with chapter number 12, electricity, and we discussed about what is an electric current. So electric current is the flow of electric charge, and electrons in an atom are the charge carriers. Electrons carry negative charge and they are responsible to carry electricity through the conductor. This electric current is given by the formula I is equal to Q upon T, where I is electric current, Q is the charge, and T is the time. The electric current is a scalar quantity and its SI unit is ampere, and it is denoted by letter capital A. Now looking at the formula I is equal to Q upon T, the SI unit of charge is coulomb and the SI unit of time is second. So I is equal to coulomb per second or coulomb upon second. So I can say that the SI unit of electric current can also be coulomb per second, and this coulomb per second is also called as an ampere. So SI unit of electric current is ampere, which is denoted by letter capital A. Then electric current is measured with the help of a device which is called as an ammeter. And I told you to remember one thing, that an ammeter is always connected in series with the circuit. And this we will discuss in detail in the later part of the video. Then there has to be something in an electrical circuit which will cause the flow of electrons, and this is nothing but a device which is called as a cell or a battery. So cell or a battery is responsible for making the electrons flow in an electrical conductor. Now one very very important thing we learned, that the direction of electric current is taken opposite to the flow of electrons. Alright, so with this figure it will make more clear to all of you. Look at the first figure. The direction of flow of electrons in an electrical circuit is from negative terminal to the positive terminal of a cell. Alright, but when electricity was discovered, during that time electrons were not discovered. So during that time the flow of electric current was supposed to be from positive terminal to the negative terminal of the battery. This flow of electrons, this flow of electric current was given the name as conventional flow of electric current. So the traditional current direction or the conventional flow of electric current is from positive terminal to the negative terminal of the battery, and it is shown like this. So I can summarize it like this, that the direction of electric current is always taken opposite to the direction of flow of electrons which carry negative charge. Now the figure to the right side of this slide will give you a clear idea about the direction of flow of electrons and the direction of flow of conventional current. So look at this diagram. The blue color arrows shows the direction of electrons which is flowing from the negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery. But the direction of conventional current is always from positive to negative terminal of the battery, which is shown by the red color arrow. Keep one thing in mind children, when we draw electrical circuit, the direction of electric current you will always show the conventional flow of electric current, the direction of conventional current, that is from positive to negative terminal of the battery. So this particular picture will give you more clear idea. Have a look at that. The blue color dots are the electrons and they are flowing from negative to positive terminal of the battery. But the direction of conventional current is shown by the red arrow, which is from positive to negative terminal of the cell or a battery. Observe this figure, children. You can see continuous flow of electrons through a copper wire. And when electrons flow continuously like this through a copper wire, we say that there is a flow of electric current. And this continuous flow of electrons through the copper wire is possible only when we attach a cell or a battery to the two ends of a conductor. But then how this cell is responsible for making the electrons to flow in one direction? What is happening inside the cell? Let's understand this with this small experiment. So we'll take two beakers, and both the beakers are attached to each other with the help of a pipe at the bottom. You keep pouring water in one beaker and you will observe that the level of the water in both the beakers always remain the same. But now I want the water to flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1 in this manner. So what changes I need to do in this case? What I'll do is I will raise the height of the beaker, and because there is rise in the height, now the water will flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. So by raising the beaker to certain height, I am actually creating a pressure difference in the water. So water flows from higher level to the lower level. And exactly this is what is required in case of the flow of electric current. So in a conductor, for electricity to flow, there has to be something which will push the electrons along. We need to apply certain force on the electrons so that they will set themselves into motion and flow in one particular direction. This force is called as an electromotive force, and the device which provides this electromotive force to the electrons is a cell or a battery. So the main purpose of battery in an electrical conductor is to give force to the electrons so that they will flow continuously in the conductor and carry current. Now see, suppose if you are given a wire which is open at both the ends, nothing is attached to the wire. Will the electricity flow through this wire? The answer is no, the electricity will not flow. Now the moment you attach a cell to the two ends of a conductor, now the electrons inside the conductor experienced a force, and so they will start moving, and when they will start moving in one particular direction, the electricity will flow. So have a look at this animated figure and it will give you a good idea about how the electric current flows through the circuit. Look over here. If towards the right side you see the electrons are lazy, they are tired and they are walking with the stick in their hand, no energy at all. The moment they enter through this cell or a battery, they experienced a force. The stick is flying away, they are getting a force, a push they are getting, and they are running literally. That means they are flowing in one particular direction. So battery or a cell play an important role to create a difference in the concentration of electrons there. It applies more force to the electrons, and so the electrons flow in one particular direction. Alright, so we can summarize it like this. The electric current will flow through the conductor only if there is a difference in electric potential between the two ends of a conductor. And this difference in the level of number of electrons at one particular end is created with the help of a cell and a battery. This difference in electrical potential between the two ends of a conductor is called as potential difference. And this potential difference in the circuit is provided by a cell or a battery. Now inside the cell, certain chemical reactions take place, and due to this chemical reaction, the difference in the level of number of electrons at one particular end is created, and so the electrons start moving from negative terminal to positive terminal of a cell or a battery. So observe this figure. So this figure will give you a better understanding about the flow of electric current. When you connect a cell to the two ends of the conducting wire, you can see the blue colored dots, which are electrons. They are in motion. They are continuously running. They are running because we have created a potential difference between the two ends of a conductor. We have created the concentration of electrons more at the negative terminal, and so they start experiencing a force and they move in one direction like this, and thus the flow of electric current gets established in a conducting wire. Now I want to define potential difference in a proper manner. So the definition of potential difference is: potential difference between the two points A and B of a conductor is the amount of work done to move a unit charge from A to B. You will understand this with the help of this figure. So look at this. A cell is connected between the two ends of a conductor. I'll give the negative terminal as end A and this is end B. Now when the charges move, when the electrons move from the end A to end B, work is done. We have seen last year that when there is a displacement of the object from one place to another, we say that work is done. So electrons are moving from A to B, point A to B. So an electric cell is creating a potential difference. So potential difference between the two points A and B of a conductor is the amount of work done to move a charge from A to B. So the charges are moving from A to B, work is done, and that is a potential difference. So our formula is potential difference is equal to work done upon charge. Work done is denoted by letter W, charge by Q, and potential difference is denoted by PD. So PD is equal to W upon Q. The SI unit of work is joule, and SI unit of charge is coulomb, and joule per coulomb is given the name as volt, and so we can say that SI unit of potential difference is volt, and it is denoted by letter capital V. Alright, now I want to define this volt. I want to define what is the meaning of 1 volt. For that, we will again make use of our formula. Potential difference is equal to work done upon the charge. Now, SI unit of potential difference is 1 volt. Alright, you look here. The potential difference, its SI unit is 1 volt. Then, SI unit of work done is joule. So, we'll write that as 1 joule. SI unit of charge is coulomb, so we have written that as 1 coulomb. So I get the formula 1 volt is equal to 1 joule upon 1 coulomb, and this will make my work easy to define 1 volt. So I'll say potential difference is said to be 1 volt when 1 joule of work is done to move a charge of 1 coulomb from one point to the other point. So this way we can define the SI unit of potential difference. Alright children, so I hope the things are clear to you. What is the meaning of potential difference and why it is necessary in the electric conductor. Alright, then the next is the device which is used to measure potential difference in an electrical circuit is called as voltmeter. And this voltmeter is always connected in parallel across the two ends where the potential difference is to be measured. So this parallel word you have to keep in mind, and I'll explain this in detail in the next part of the video. The figure which is flashing at the bottom of this slide is a voltmeter. This is a device which is used to measure potential difference. This is the positive terminal of the voltmeter and this is the negative terminal of the voltmeter. Nowadays, voltmeter is also available, which gives us the digital readings. So there is no need for us to see the scale there. It gives us direct digital values. Alessandro Antonio Volta, the great Italian physicist, who is the one who invented electric battery. Volta was performing electrical experiments when he was just the age 18 years, and his invention of battery in the year 1796 revolutionized the use of electricity. So the great work in the field of electricity, and to honor his great work, the unit of potential difference is given the name as volt. So children, whatever we did today, whatever we studied today, based on that, we have a numerical. Let's see that numerical first. And the numerical is, how much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across 2 points having potential difference of 12 volts. I told you the moment you write the numerical, first you have to write what is given to you. So you have given the potential difference as 12 volts, charge is given as 2 coulomb, you have to find out how much work is done. And we have the formula, potential difference is equal to work done upon the charge. So we can change the formula to work done. So work done is equal to potential difference into charge. Substitute the values. That is 12 volt into 2 coulomb. So your answer is 24 joules. So work done is 24 joules. Based on today's video lesson, we have some questions for you. Name the device that helps to maintain a potential difference across a conductor. A very, very obvious and easy answer. It is a cell or a battery. What is meant by saying the potential difference between the two points is 1 volt? So actually we have to define the SI unit of potential difference, that is 1 volt. So we will say it like this. Potential difference is said to be 1 volt when 1 joule of work is done to move a charge of 1 coulomb from one end to other end. Alright. Third is a numerical. How much energy is given to each coulomb of a charge passing through a 6 volt battery? How much energy is given? So work done and energy is the same. So you have to actually find out W here. W is equal to V into Q. Volt is given to you as 6 volt, and coulomb, each coulomb means 1 coulomb charge. Alright. So that will be 6 joule of work, or how much energy is given. 6 joule of energy should be given. That should be your answer. Alright. So I hope the understanding about potential difference is clear to you. I suggest please go through the video once again. It is easy to understand. And see both the videos together, so that electric current and the potential difference, both the concepts will be once again revised by you. So see you with a new topic in the next video lesson. Till then, bye and take care.